Welcome back to the gallery. Well, I've been wandering again, and not surprisingly, the subject of my thinking was stimulated by one of those email newsletter that I receive. This one was from The Art of Nonconformity, aka Chris Guillebeau. If you haven't heard about him, he's a very interesting man. Sort of potted biography. Initially, he was a blogger who blogged in the area of travel hacking. His great passion was, or passion project, was to visit every country in the world, and he's finally managed to do that. And he's branched out. He's written a number of books about side hustles, $100 startup. He has a podcast on side hustles, a website blog called The Art of Nonconformity. He's got some fantastic free resources on it about how to live an exceptional life, really. Can really recommend them. Perhaps I'll remember to put a link in the description below, but so often I say that and, well, I forget. Never mind. He's been talking about in this newsletter an interesting idea that and one that fits in with his general sort of territory of thought. He wrote about how a sort of universal operating system tends towards average. Sort of law of average rather than the law of averages. And he illustrates this by looking at, for example, the military. If they are stocking uniforms, well, they get some kind of broad picture of general sizes of the demographic that will enlist or be conscripted. And that works for most people, but for those with very large feet, for example, their boots will simply provide you with blisters and other sort of foot ailments. Because they cater for the average and you're not average. And we can extend this idea out into pretty much any area. And so often I find myself thinking about music, and I suppose that's a good place to go with this. The music industry equally caters for average. I mean, their objective is to sell millions of records. And that means having something that will appeal to as many people as possible and alienate as few. I remember talking to one of my noisy neighbours once, and I used the word banal to describe the music that they were listening to. It was one of those slightly drunken barroom conversations, and perhaps I was being deliberately provocative. I've known to be deliberately provocative before, and you might have noticed. He took offence to this, and perhaps not unreasonably, and perhaps I was trying to be a little poke in the ribs-ish with the comment. I was also being honest, because I thought the music was banal, and I think by any definition of banal, it is. It is music to appeal to masses of people. It is uncreative. The lyrics are unthreatening. The rhythm is obvious, immediately identifiable. It's uncreative. It's banal. But he, of course, picked up on the fact that we use the word banal in a slightly pejorative way. And in this context of talking about averages, my good friend Seth Godin uses the word mediocre. Well, that would also be offensive to many. But the truth of the matter is that the music that they are listening to, my noisy neighbour and his friends, is not designed to be interesting, above average, or challenging. It is designed to be instantly recognizable and soothing and have a beat, a rhythm, that the locals can dance their dance style to. So banal is perfect for their sort of musical objectives. And Chris Guillebeau talks about how the truth of the matter is that in most things, of course, average is what we want. We don't want something terribly challenging. You're in the shop and you're not a MasterChef contestant or the executive chef in a Michelin star restaurant, probably buying ordinary, plain old table salt, cheap as chips, is what you want. Do you want the pink Himalayan rock salt? I mean, would you really notice the difference? Probably not. If you're in Brazil, you might go for something that is a little fractionally above average. You'll buy the rock salt. Why? Because it's the local barbecuing style. You get a big lump, top of the rump, cap of the rump, and you sort of cut in and smother the layering of fat with rock salt. And it sort of, as the fat permeates the meat that you're roasting above the barbecue, well, it's wonderful. But you don't need Himalayan pink rock salt. The plain old rock salt will do just fine. And so in most of what we're doing, average is okay. But what Chris argues for is that we need to find these ideas, where actually we want to go well beyond average. The famous French author, I think the most well-known novel, Madame Bovary, Gustave Flaubert. I'm terrible with French pronunciation, so I apologize to my French listeners. Anyway, Gustave made the comment, and I'm paraphrasing, that we need to be boring in our daily habits so that we can be wild and original in our art. And that's the truth of the matter. There's a sort of a freedom in selecting the average, because it just takes away all the thoughts and effort in making a decision. And on the whole, average is just fine if it's something that you don't really care about. For example, my friends, the music they're listening to, they don't really care about music. They care about music that they can dance to. And that's what's really important to them. And of course, this isn't true for everybody. It's true for the average. And I think this is an important point. I would argue that all of us actually need to find this area where we are very much non-average. If we are absolutely normal and average in everything, there is something slightly unsettling. It's a little bit like those people who are always very, very nice. There's something deeply disturbing about that. You kind of wonder what is being hidden from view. It's a bit like the Jim Carrey character in The Truman Show. And actually, in a way, The Truman Show is probably a good metaphor or example, because there is something underneath the surface. It is completely unreal, as Mr. Truman discovers. And I think perhaps that's the way in to realizing why we all need to find our place of exceptional, of extraordinary, of non-average. Because otherwise, perhaps in being totally average in absolutely everything, what we are is becoming Mr. Truman. We are being manipulated by forces out there to consume what they want us to consume, whether it is stuff or ideas or values or ways of being. And in some area, we need to break free and become ourselves. And in truly becoming ourselves, I think inevitably we will find little pockets of extraordinariness. Areas where what we do, say, think, how we behave is anything but average, but is very much us. And in that journey, we will find other people who are doing the same. And I think this is very, very important. So that's it for this week. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And until next week, I hope you find joy in your little pocket of non-ordinariness. So, from a sunny Brazil,